Now that we have our MP Connection Manager class created, we can start to use it. We're going to use this in our start view where we have to take care of our last game type. Remember, we hid that start button because what we want to do is to display all of our peers who have advertised their willingness to play and select one of them. So I'm going to break this out into its own view that I can embed in the start view. This will need access to our Connection Manager, as will our game, so it's best to inject this into the environment. But remember, we'll need to pass the name of a player when we instantiate it, so we can't do this in our app entry point, but we can do that in our start view since we pass in that value in our initializer. So in start view, create a state object for this Connection Manager that is of type MPConnectionManager. Then, since this object has not been initialized, we can do that in our init function, and since it's a property wrapper, we'll need to use an underscore to address it. Then, we can create a state object type using the wrapped value argument, where we create a new instance of our MP Connection Manager, passing in your name. When we inject this new object into the environment, our other views and their subviews will have access to it. And remember, in our MP Connection Manager class, I have that setup function that will have to be called from our game view. That means whenever we present our game view from here at the full screen cover, we should inject our Connection Manager into the environment. Let's go to game view then and create the environment object there, and also make sure that our preview gets an instance. Then on the onAppear function where we reset our game, we can, if our game type is peer, call the Connection Manager setup function, passing in the game services game object so that our Connection Manager can use any of those functions. Now we need a view that will present all who are going to advertise their availability to play. So inside that multi-peer connectivity group, let's create a new SwiftUI file and call it MPPeersView. It will require access to both our game service and our Connection Manager environment objects. So we'll create two environment objects for them. And again, we'll need to fix the preview. And for the Connection Manager object, we'll have to use a string for your name, so again we'll just use sample. Next, we'll be using this view to invite someone to play or accept an invitation. So, if accepted by either, we'll want to trigger the presentation of the game, and that's handled by the start game property in our start view. So we'll need to pass in that as a binding. Then we'll need to add a constant binding to false for that property in our preview. Now, in the body, let's embed the text view inside a VStack. And I'm going to change the string to just say available players. I'll follow that with a list that iterates over all of the Connection Manager's available peers, where the ID is self. And we can do that because each MC peer ID is unique, and we made sure that we only add new users to that array if they don't already exist. So this will provide us with a peer that we can iterate over. Within the H stack, we'll create a text view using the peer's display name, and follow that with a spacer. Then we'll have a button that will allow us to select them. So the label will be select. And then in the action, we'll set the game's game type to peer. We'll use the Connection Manager's nearby service browser to invite the peer, passing in our peer to our Connection Manager session. And then the context will be nil because we're not sending any additional data. And we'll set a timeout of 30. Then we can set the game's player one's name to the connection manager's myPeerId.displayName, which is the display name for myPeerId, which is my name or the your name property. And then the game two player's name will be the display name of the selected peer that we'll be inviting. And let's set that button to a bordered prominent style. While in start view, which will be displaying this view, if we receive an invitation before we get a chance to send one out, we'll have the option to accept or reject it. And this comes by way of the connection manager's invitation handler. But remember, we also created a Boolean property in connection manager that is received invite that is set to true when it gets one, so we can use this to present an alert. So let's attach that to our H stack. And for the title, we can use the string received invitation from, and then use string interpolation to use the connection manager's received from property that is a MC peer, and we'll use the display name from there. Now this is optional, so if it doesn't exist, it actually will, but instead of force unwrapping, let's just enter unknown as the name. Is presented is bound to the connection manager's received invite property. I won't be needing a message closure, so let's remove that and stick with just actions for this alert. For our actions, we'll have two buttons, one for accept invite and one for reject. For the accept action, we can unwrap the closure, which is the invitation handler, from our connection manager, if it exists. Then we can use that function passing in true and the connection manager session. This now establishes a new session. We can set our game player one name to the display name that we received from the invite, which is the same string we used in the alert. Player two name then will be my device, so we can use the connection manager's my peer ID's display name. And then we can set our game type to peer. For the rejection, we can again unwrap the invitation handler function, but this time pass in false instead of true, and nil for the session. When we tap on this button, then we'll be sending information to our connected user, which will be received by our delegate function as a start of the game. This then gives us enough information to complete that function that we left incomplete in the last section of our MP Connection Manager class. So let's return to it and scroll down to the did receive delegate function of the MC session delegate extension. So here's the case where we broke. So first we'll do a guard check to unwrap the player name from our game move object to make sure that we got one. Otherwise, we'll just return. Then we can check to see if that name matches the name already established for player one of our game object. And if so, we can make that player current. If not, we'll make the other player current. Back in MPPeersView, let me find the closing bracket on that H stack. Now, when our view appears, we want to advertise our availability to play and start browsing for others. So let me add that on appear modifier to our V stack. Then we can set the connection manager's is available to play property to true. And then we can call the connection manager start browsing function. Now when we accept an invite or have an invitation accepted, this view will disappear and the GameView will be presented. So let's add an onDisappear block after the onAppear one, and within there, we can stop browsing, and we can stop advertising, and we can set our isAvailableToPlay option to false. Then we can watch for changes on the paired property, which initially is false, but when it changes, we'll get a new value and we'll set our start game to that new value. Now in start view, we can replace the empty view for the game type switch statement in the VStack for our peer case, which will present the MCPeerView, passing in our start game state boolean property that triggers the game view's full screen cover, and we can inject our connection manager state object into the environment so our MPPeersView will have access to those game functions and properties. Now I don't know if you noticed, but I have my test iPhone connected to Xcode and it's running iOS 15. So let me run it on this device. I'm using QuickTime to display to my screen, so let me bring it into view. Now, because it's a first launch, I'm required to enter my name as expected. So let's enter Colin, which is actually my first name. Now I'm going to select the Challenge a Friend mode. Now, the first time I use this app, I'm presented with a request to find and connect to devices on the local network. And that string here is the one that we entered in the plist. So let me just tap OK. I see that there is no one yet who wants to play. But I am advertising my availability as Colin. So let me now run on my iPhone 14 Pro simulator at the same time. I'm going to minimize Xcode so that we can see both of our devices clearly. I'm not asked to enter my name here because I entered it already and this device is Stuart. So let me challenge a friend on the simulator. When this screen appears, I see that Colin is available to play on the simulator, and on the phone, I see that Stuart is available to play, and the game can be initiated by either player. So let me tap on the select button on my real phone to invite Stuart on the simulator. The request is made and Stuart on the simulator gets that alert where he can accept or reject. Well, let's accept. And when that's done, the items are paired and start game gets set to true on both devices, and the game view appears. All we have to do now is to fix our code that will send our next actions over. So we'll need to add code in our actions to send our paired player if the game type is peer. So within game view, for our first start button for player one, if the game type is equal to peer, we can create a game move object that will be an MP game move object where the action is start and the player name will be the game.player1.name. And since we're not making any moves, the index will be nil. Having that, then we can use the connection manager's send function to send this game move over to the other paired device. Well, the second button for the second player is going to be pretty much identical. The only difference is that our player name will be the player 2 name. In the new game button, we do a similar check for the game move. And this time, though, for our game move, the action will be reset. And there'll be no need to pass in a player name or an index, so both will be nil. And once we do that, we can send it on using that send function from our connection manager. For the end game, once more, we'll do a check on the game type. And we'll create the same kind of MP game move as we did for our new game, but the action is end, and then pass that on. I do want to add some more conditions to our game board's disable check though. So add an OR operator, and we'll check if the game type is a peer and the connection manager's my peer display name is not equal to the game.currentPlayer name. And this will prevent me from making a move while it's not my turn. Switching now over to square view, I'll need access to the connection manager object from the environment. And as always, we'll have to inject an instance in the preview provider. Now when a button is tapped then, if the game type is peer, we can create our MP game move with an action of move this time and pass along the my peer ID's display name from our connection manager property. And this time we'll have to pass in the index of the object that's being moved and send that over. I think we're done. So let's test. First, let me run on my simulator. Then, let me run on the test iPhone SE. As I see, when I select challenge a friend on both devices, we see the opposing player is available. I'll have the simulator challenge Colin on the iPhone SE, and I'll accept on the phone. On the simulator, I'm going to tell the iPhone to start, and that action is sent over, and the game is started with Colin's player button showing in green. And now, when on the iPhone I tap on a square, the move is sent over and Stuart is now active. I can continue on back and forth now until a winner is declared or we've reached a stalemate. On the simulator, after we have ended a game, I decide that I no longer want to play against Colin. I can choose a different game mode. And when I do that, Colin on the iPhone no longer sees me as being available because I've stopped advertising. Now there's one thing I don't like though, and that's that not displaying while on the iPhone SE. And that's because I added that extra button to change the name, and originally I'd not counted on that. So let's go back and adjust the frame of the image so that it will fit on the smallest device. Back in start view then, I can find that image of the launch screen and make it first resizable, scale to fit, and I'll set a frame of a width of 200. Let's test then once more on the iPhone SE. That's much better. So just for completeness sake then, let's commit our finished project to the Git repository. Well, I hope you've learned some things from this video series, and I would really like to thank Chris Ching for allowing me to share my passion on his channel. Thanks so much for sharing your time with me, and I hope you enjoyed it.